Hey everyone, welcome back to the NABARD Grade A 5-day question series. And in this, I am going to discuss about the ARD question, the mixed ARD questions. Also, before starting with the video, let me just tell you that we are giving the NABARD Grade A 2019 mocks, that too for 999 rupees. And in this, the 10 mocks of phase 1 along with the 5 mocks of phase 2 are included. The gross amount of this is 1500 rupees, but you can use the coupon code MOCKS, that is MOCKS MOCKS, and avail the discount to get it for 999 rupees. So do not forget to buy the NABARD Grade A 2019 MOCKS, as it's very important to be prepared for the examination. Also, the link for the same is available in the description box, so do not forget to click on the link. You'll be redirected to the page to buy the mock test. Let's begin with the first question for today. So golden revolution is related to, now there are different types of revolutions and you must know about each and every revolution. First thing, it's not difficult to remember, and second, they are very important with respect to the examination. So golden revolution is related to honey production. Now you might be confused regarding the golden revolution and the golden fiber revolution. So golden revolution is different and golden fiber revolution is different. Where the golden fiber revolution is related to the jute production and the golden revolution is related to the honey production, horticulture production or the fruits production. So these all combine up to the golden revolution. Now let's look at these revolutions one by one. So blue revolution is related to the fisheries production. Brown revolution is related to the leather production. Green revolution, we know that it's related to the food grains production, the most important one. Another one being the pink revolution, which is related to the shrimp production, the prawns production or the onion production. So these all are included in the pink revolution. Silver revolution is related to the egg and the poultry production. Similarly, the silver fiber is related to the cotton revolution. So it's mentioned over here that silver fiber revolution is related to the cotton production. Similarly, golden fiber and golden and silver and silver fiber. White revolution, the dairy development and milk production. So these are related to or known as the white revolution. The oilseed production is known as yellow revolution. Gray revolution is related to the fertilizer or wool production. Next, the round revolution, which is related to the potato, and red revolution, which is related to meat and tomato production. What you can do is just pause the video, go through these once again, and you will be done with the revolutions. Now moving on to the next question. So which one of the following app is launched in Tamil Nadu for farmers to provide access for different type of services? Now many websites, you will find that they are providing the 9 services, but some websites mention it to be the 12 services. So no fixed information is being provided. Therefore, I have taken up it to be different types of services which are restricted towards farmers. Now what will help you in identifying the application? So it's the state Tamil Nadu. So in 2018, Tamil Nadu government, they launched this Ujjavan app where they will be providing different types of services. Now what types of services would be provided? So the farm subsidies, the crop insurance, the weather forecast for the next 4 days, the season fertilizer stock, these all services are provided under this Ujjavan app. These all are the applications related to the farmers. So some important ones, so the Pusa Krishi application. So Pusa Krishi app was launched in 2016 and the initiative was to take the technology to the farm fields. Basic agenda is to take the technology or make the farmers aware about the technology. Also, it used to provide information related to the new variety of crop which are developed by the ICAR, that is the Indian Council of Agriculture Research. So ICAR, that is the Indian Council of Agriculture Research, the crops which are developed by this institute, they were being, the information related to those were updated in the Pusa Krishi application. Similarly, if we talk about the agri-market application, so it was used to get the market price of the crops in the market within the 50 kilometer of range of the device location. So do remember these apps and their basic agendas. Next question is related to the State of Forest Report 2017. Very, very important report. And also, no new report has come up in 2019. Thus, we are relying on the 2017 data for all the information. So, which of the following is incorrect with respect to the State of Forest Report 2017? Now, there are different criteria categories which have been defined by the State of Forest Report while they were doing this survey. So, let's look at that first. So, the forest cover has been classified in terms of the canopy density classes. The first class is the very dense forest, where all lands with the tree canopy density of 70% and above, they are being classified as the very dense forest. So here it's above 70%. Next one is 70 to 40%. Another one is less than 40% but greater than equal to 10%. Next one is less than 10%. Next one is less than 10%. And the last one, the non-forest area, where the lands not included any of the above and include water. So this is known as the, or these are the forest cover classification as per the State of Forest report. Now let's read each one of these one by one. So all lands with the tree canopy density of 70% and above, correct, they are classified as very dense. Moderately dense, we know that 40% and more and less than 70%. For open forest, the tree canopy needs to be 10% and more, but less than 40%. So this is incorrect. Scrub is the degraded forest land with a canopy density of less than 10%. So again, correct statement. So which one of the following is the incorrect? That is related to the open forest. So it's important to remember about this information, the forest cover classification with respect to the canopy density classes. Moving on to the next question, so which state has ranked first in terms of the maximum forest cover as per the State of Forest Report 2017? Now there are three criteria which needs to be taken care of. That first one is the maximum forest cover. Maximum forest cover. Next one is the maximum forest or highest forest cover, but in terms of the percentage of the geographical area. So in terms of the geographical area, that is different from the maximum forest cover. And the last one is the maximum increase in terms of the forest cover. So these three are the different states. The first one in terms of the maximum forest cover is Madhya Pradesh. So Madhya Pradesh has the total maximum or the forest cover of 77,414 square kilometers. If we talk about the cover in respect to the geographical area, so Lakshadweep is at the first position, where it has been ranked first in terms of the percentage of the forest cover with respect to the geographical area. That is 90.33% of the land of Lakshadweep is covered with forest. In terms of the maximum increase in the forest cover, so Andhra Pradesh is at the first position. So these are some of the very important facts which you must remember with respect to the State of Forest Report 2017. Now we talk about India as a whole. So India is ranked at the 10th position in the world with 24.4% of the land area that is under the forest and tree cover. Moving on to the next question, so which of the following risk is not included in the Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana? So you need to identify which of the following is not classified or categorized under the, or not included as a risk cover under the Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana. The first one is the prevented sowing or germination risk. Now this risk is included under the Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana as the risk could arise due to the deficit of rainfall or adverse seasonal or weather conditions, they are being included. Next is the post-harvest losses. So these are also included. So suppose they provide coverage up to maximum period of 2 weeks from the harvesting of the crop. So the coverage is provided only up to a maximum period, but the coverage is provided, so it is included under the Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana. Next one is the localized calamity risk. So this is also included. So any loss or damage which is notified or identified because of the landslide, the cloudburst or natural fire, these are all included under the Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana. Next one is the war risk. So war risk are not included under the Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana, and along with this the nuclear risk are also not included. So the risk which arises out of the war and nuclear risk or malicious damage or other preventable risk, it's important to note this word preventable risk. So these risks are also not included under the Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana. Next one is the risk of the risk by the attack of wild animals. So this is also covered. The states may consider providing this as an add-on coverage to the crop losses. So these all are provided, and along with this there is one more risk, which is the risk which is being covered till the sowing to harvesting period. So basically the standing crop risk is also insured under this PMFBY. Now another very important thing which you need to remember regarding this Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana is the maximum premium which is payable by the farmer. So for the kharif crop it stands at 2% for the sum insured, and for the rabi crops it stands at 1.5% of the sum insured. This is with respect to the food grain crops. So it's important to note that it is restricted towards the food grain crops. When we are talking about the annual commercial and the annual horticulture crop, that both for the kharif and rabi season, also the perennial horticulture crops on the pilot basis, these are all included at the 5% premium for both kharif and rabi season. Now the question arises, in which year this Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana was launched. So mention your answers in the comment section below, that when was this Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana launched. And another one more important question for you is, Ratna is the variety of which of the following. I'll be telling about the answer of this question in the next video. Do mention your answers in the comment section below, that Ratna is the variety of which of the following, along with the launch year of the Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana. I hope you are preparing well for the examination. Do not forget to share these videos who are preparing for the NABARD examination, as we are covering the different topics in terms of MCQs. And do not forget to subscribe to our channel as well. And we'll be coming up with the next video soon. Thank you so much for watching the video.